Gentleman reserves. The gentleman from Massachusetts is recognized.
Yeah, Mr. Speaker, I'm not going to waste my time debating misinformation, but my friend is talking about what he's talking about is a false government takeover. But what about the people who tried to take over our democracy on January 6th? What about what happened here on January 6th? Why is there no interest in getting to the truth? They come up with this instead. And again, I'm still waiting for somebody to respond to President Trump's statement that Insurrection Day took place on November 3rd. Do you really believe that? Is that what we have come to, where my friends on the other side would embrace such a shocking and such an offensive statement? We had a free and fair election, and this is what the former president, who my friends are all so afraid of, what he says. I now yield 2 minutes to the gentlewoman from Pennsylvania, a distinguished member of the Rules Committee, Ms. Scanlon.
Pennsylvania is recognized for 2 minutes.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. I rise in strong support of this rule and the underlying resolution. There are moments in our country's history when we are presented with stark choices, choices between right and wrong. And the violence of January 6th has made it clear that we're at such a moment. January 6th was a shocking assault on our government. On the orders of the former president, thousands of rioters destroyed public property, gravely injured police officers, terrorized lawmakers, and invaded the Capitol to halt the certification of the Electoral College required by the Constitution. That day cannot be minimized or swept under the carpet because the forces that inspired it, that inspired that attack, are still stoking the fires of chaos and conspiracy. Congress has tasked a bipartisan select committee with investigating the January 6th attack, and that committee has outlined why it needs Steve Bannon's testimony to fully understand the events leading up to that attack. However, when subpoenaed to testify, Mr. Bannon told the select committee to pound sand. Mr. Bannon is a private citizen. He is not above the law and cannot refuse to obey a subpoena any more than you or I or any American can. Neither Mr. Bannon nor the former president have made any credible legal arguments to shield his testimony. Patriotism demands that anyone with knowledge of that dark day come forward, and the rule of law and our Constitution demand that everyone in this Congress support this investigation. I'm incredibly disappointed that Republican leadership and so many of their colleagues continue to oppose any attempt to investigate the January 6th attack. They oppose legislation to create a bipartisan commission, they oppose the creation of the Select Committee, and they're now trying to prevent the committee from carrying out its work. This is not a time for games or delays, all of which have allowed the former president and his allies like Mr. Bannon to escape accountability thus far. This is a time for courage. The courage to protect our Constitution and our national integrity. I'm grateful to the members of the Select Committee for having the courage to put loyalty to country over partisan politics. Mr. Speaker, I strongly urge all of my colleagues to support this rule. Thank you. I yield back.